that we're going to take a look at today. One, the case where the limit exists and the point exists. Two, the case where the limit exists but the point does not exist. And three, the case where both the limit and the point do not exist. Let's say you and I want to meet for lunch, but we work at opposite ends of town from each other. So we decide we're going to meet someplace in the middle. How about someplace nice? So we decide to drive to the restaurant. Each of us driving along the road representing the limit to the restaurant representing the point. As we can see, the limit exists, the road leading to the restaurant existed. The point, the restaurant itself exists, and it is in the location we expected it to be in. So this is the case where both the limit and the point exist. Which is good news for us, because it means we can sit down, have a nice meal, and catch up. Now let's take a look at the second scenario. This is a very important one to consider. This is the case where the limit exists, but the point does not exist. This is a little bit different from what you might have seen in algebra, and only really happens in a calculus course. So in this case, again, you and I decide we're going to drive from opposite ends of town and meet at our favorite restaurant in the middle. This time, the road did in fact exist, leading to where we thought the restaurant should have been. But when we get there, we discover, wow, there's an empty parking lot here. The restaurant had actually moved down the road, but neither one of us could remember that. Well, at least we agreed on where we were supposed to have met, and now we're sitting in an empty parking lot together. So, what do you say? Let's find a new restaurant and go eat there instead. So in this case, we've discovered that the limit existed, our road leading to where we thought the point should have been existed, but the restaurant itself was not in fact there. So this is a case where the function does not exist in that location, however the limit does exist. And if the function exists, it simply doesn't exist in the same place that the limit does, so we'll get two different values. One value for the limit, one value for the function. In this third case, neither the point nor the limit actually exist. Unlike the previous example, where we drove from opposite ends of town and wound up in an empty parking lot together, where we were at least agreeing on the location of the point even though the restaurant had moved, in this case, it would be like driving from opposite ends of town from each other, both of us forgetting where the restaurant was located and winding up at different locations. Neither of us is in the same parking lot together, the restaurant is not at either of our locations, and therefore we miss out on lunch and don't get to eat today. So sad. This is a non-replaceable discontinuity, meaning we cannot fix this scenario. The point is simply not at either of the locations, and the limit from the left-hand side and the limit from the right-hand side do not agree on the location, so the limit does not exist.